think you're going to look completely inappropriate and slutty, so just pick something and let's go.
Mum?
Warren, behave. You look lovely, darling.
Thank you. All right, come on, Brett. I'm ready.
About time.
So whose party is this?
Elizabeth.
And where is the party? Which is where?
We need places on the fridge, Mum. Can we go?
Oh, okay, okay. Yes, of course you can. But don't drink too much, especially you, Jessica. And if you are going to drink, do not get behind the wheel of that car.
Okay.
We'll come and take a cab, okay?
Okay.
Oh, and if you are going to stay over, please let me know. I don't want to be up half the night worrying about you.
Okay, okay, Mum. We got to go. All right, let's go. Come on.
Have fun.
And stay safe.
Will do. Bye, Mum. Bye. Don't worry about the shoes. Just get in the car. Come on.
here, not from you, by the way, that my daughter's in a serious accident. I'm not going to come and check on her. Don't pretend. I've always cared, Leah. You know that. It's not about you and I, it's about our daughter, okay? It's about Jess.
Yeah, it was finalised about 6 weeks ago. But don't worry about it. We don't.
Exactly. And the only good thing about them being divorced is they're a lot happier.
That and two of everything.
Just hear me out. Leah, she's my daughter as well.
Okay, 10 minutes.
Sure.
And do you make coffee?
Fine.
Hey, kiddo.
Hi.
What are you reading?
Oh, nothing really, just something I found in my drawer. What's that?
I just came in to see how you were feeling. How are you feeling?
Well, my leg's currently playing host to a metal plate. My lung's got a hole in it again. I'm recovering from re-enlargement surgery from a dislocated disc in my spine. I can't remember anything from the past 3 months, except that I was in a pretty bad accident. Oh, and now I find out my parents got divorced while I was in hospital fighting for my life. So I'm absolutely fantastic.
What are you doing here, Joe?
Making a coffee.
No. Right now, in general. What are you really doing here in general?
I told you, checking up on my daughter. She was in a serious accident, Leah.
Yeah, I know that, Joe, because I was the one by her bedside, day in and day out, trying to reassure her when she woke up in the middle of the night, crying her eyes out. While you were in Australia with your two-bit whore.
Her name's Sharon, and she's not a two-bit whore. She's my, you know what, it doesn't matter. And you're right, I was in Australia, and I wasn't living it up. Do you know how hard it was for me to find out my daughter was in a serious car accident and it not be from you?
I can clearly see that you haven't forgot what sarcasm is then.
I'm sorry, it's just so frustrating not being able to remember what happened. And it makes it 10 times worse when you're being asked how you're feeling by the same people every time they walk into the room.
They don't ask you how you're feeling every time you walk into the room.
Hey twin, how you feeling?
What?
Never mind. What's with the DVD and popcorn?
Well, I thought seeing as Jess was cooped up in the hospital for almost a month, that she might want to spend some sibling time with her twin brother, you know? Watch a couple films, maybe even chow down on some popcorn.
No, that's so sweet. Hang on, where's my invite?
I don't know, check your inbox.
Must be really hard for you, Joe. It took you all of 3 weeks to get here.
I told you, I lost my phone. If I hadn't, I would have got the first flight and I would have been there first thing in the morning. Them kids are my life, Leah. You know that. I'd do anything for them.
Oh, you even moved to Australia?
I had to. After we filed for divorce, everything just got weird between us. And I thought, I'll give you what you wanted.
Is Dad still downstairs talking to Mum?
Yeah, I think so. Why?
No reason. Well, actually, there is a reason. It's super quiet down there. Normally Mum's thrown a plate or something valuable at his head by now.
Maybe they're just talking.
About what? They're divorced.
They probably do have a lot to talk about. I mean, I don't think they've spoken properly since they filed for it.
Do you think one of us should go down and check if they're still alive?
No. No, no. They'll be fine.
And what was that, Joe? What did I want? What did I really want?
Space, Leah. You wanted space.
Space! Joe, we were married for almost 21 years, yeah? We have three beautiful kids together. What I wanted was you to tell me that we were making a mistake. Hmm? That it was over between you two, that it meant nothing. But no. You agreed, and then you fled to the other side of the world.
I wish that I did try to make it work. You know, I really do. But I knew I hurt you. And yeah, you probably would have forgiven me. But in the back of your mind, it wouldn't have been the same. If I went to work or went out with my friends, you'd have been paranoid. You just hate me all over again. So I thought I'd just give you what you wanted, space.
Yeah, you sure did that. It must have been really easy for you to flee the country with the woman you cheat your wife on for.
Let's just watch a film and relax a bit. It's been a hectic few weeks. And Alex, you can join us if you like.
Oh, gee, thanks.
Oh, you're welcome.
Guys. Can I ask you guys something first?
Sure.
It's about the accident. I know it was pretty bad, but how bad was it?
Jess, why do you want to know?
I don't, but I feel like I need to. It's eating away at me not knowing. I have to know what happened. I wake up every morning and I can't remember anything about that night. Not even how it happened. All I remember is people telling me that I'm lucky to be alive and that it was pretty bad, but how bad is pretty bad?
You know what? Okay, you hate me. It's fine. You know what? After everything I did, I'd hate me too. It's understandable. But I'm begging you, Leah, don't take my kids away from me. Don't stop me from being a dad to my kids, especially when Jess is gonna need a dad. Just as well as her mum. Hate me, that's fine. But don't take my kids away.
I don't hate you. And I'm not gonna take the kids away from you. At one point, I actually imagined myself constantly stabbing you in the eyeball. But I know I can never do that. Because, believe it or not, I still love you. I mean, it's hard not to. We worked together for 21 years. But you're right.
Please, I need to know.
Jess, it was pretty bad.
Yeah, you say that, but what does that even mean? Was there bleeding? Was I unconscious? I need to know.
It was fucking terrible, okay? It was absolutely fucking terrible, Jess. I'm still having nightmares about it. Just seeing you lying there on that stretcher, you got blood gushing out of you every fucking where, and I'm just standing there watching them stick tubes in you. I thought he was gonna die, Jess. I thought he was gonna die and it would have been all my fault. I should have gotten out of the car sooner. I should have pushed you out of the way. I should have been the one that got hit, not you. Now you're lying there, all battered up and bruised, with broken bones and punctured organs, and I have to live with the fact that I almost lost you. So you want to know how bad it was? That's how fucking bad it was.
Why didn't you say anything?
It's not exactly my favourite topic now, is it?
I'm sorry, and what?
I said you're right.
Me, Joseph Christopher Knox, I'm right. Are we in like some alternate universe or something?
Look, what I'm trying to say is, I'm not going to stop you from seeing the kids, if that's what they want.
Listen to me, both of you, especially you. Even if you were to wake up tomorrow and you couldn't remember anything, not even my name, and you, even if you couldn't cope with all of this, I would never judge you for it. It wouldn't even dent the level of affection I have for you both. And do you know why?
Because you love us?
Exactly. Because I love you, and I will always love you. I'm your big sister. That's what I'm for. So remember that. Wow. That got very emotional very fast. How about that film then?
You say that again. What films did you choose? The films, which ones did you choose?
The Hunger Games, 17 Again, and this new one I got the other day called Trial and Error.
I think we should watch all of them.
Okay, cool. Sounds like a plan.
I'll draw the curtains.
Do you remember Brighton? It was the twins' birthday.
Which birthday was that again?
The fourth. And Warren thought he was a pirate.
Oh yeah, I remember. He kept trying to steal the other people's fishing boat for some reason.
Do you remember Jessie's face?
She looked at him like he was an absolute idiot. And she's been giving that same look ever since. Gosh.
Do you ever think what would happen if we didn't file for divorce?
Oh, don't, would you? Please don't.
What? I'm asking. By your defensive quick shutdown on the subject, I take that as a yeah.
Yes, I used to. But I don't anymore. And neither should you, because you're with Sharon now, yeah?
Yeah, but Sharon's not you, is she?
No, she's not me. She's the one you cheated on me with. You remember that?
Oh, I'm going to get that every time. I said I'm sorry.
It seems what you have with Sharon is real. So, I guess... what I'm trying to say is... that I forgive you.
I better get going.
Where are you staying?
On the sofa, I'm my parents.
From what I can remember, that sofa wasn't very comfortable.
No, but it's 20 minutes away and I'm close if anything's needed.
Okay. Joe, I can't believe I'm going to ask you this, but why don't you just stay here?
I didn't think that was an option.
Well, it's not as if we're going to be sharing the same bed now, is it? We can stay in the guest room.
Okay, thanks.
I'm doing this for the kids, yeah? They're going to be their father as well.
Of course. Speaking of the kids, where are they?
Warren did mention something about movies before he raided the kitchen cupboard. For them and our kids, they will be out like a light in the next 20 minutes or so. And gone for the day.
Do you want to check up on them, like, make sure everything's all right? Sort of like we used to do when they were little.
Yeah, okay, yeah. One month.
This was always your favourite part of the day.
Still is.
Patient Jessica.
It's Jess actually, and considering I'm the only one here in a wheelchair, I'm going to go ahead and say yeah, I'm your new patient.
I'm Luke, and I'm going to be your main physiotherapist.
What about him?
That's Dylan, and he's still doing his training, so he won't be doing much physio with you today, Jess.
So why is he here?
Experience. He doesn't think I'm experienced enough. Isn't that right, big bro?
Oh, so you're brothers?
Well, half brothers. We have the same dad, if you can call him that.
Right, well then, today we're going to start off small with some basic stretching. I understand you're having your cast taken off soon, so we'll probably... Sorry, I've got to take this deal. You got her.
Yeah.
Deal? What are you, a rug rat?
What?
The rug rats, do you want Phil? Oh, come on. You must have seen the Rugrats at some point in your childhood.
No, sorry. Right, so I'm going to teach you some basic stretching techniques that are going to keep your hamstring from getting cramped up whilst you've got your cast on. You can just pass me your left leg and stretch it out as hard as you can.
How have you not seen the Rugrats? That and Jimmy Neutron are the only reasons I watch Nickelodeon sometimes.
Well, I was more of a CBBC guy myself. Right, can I have the right leg now, please? Stretch as hard as you can.
We're seriously going to have to talk about your taste in TV at some point.
If you say so, perfect. Right, now, could you just place your left leg on my thigh for me, please? Stretch it as hard as you can, keeping your back straight and your other leg bent. What?
Nothing, it just hurts a little.
Oh, sorry.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine, it's just a cough.
Sorry about that. Bill, I take it he's showing you the basic stretching exercises?
Actually, we only got to the hamstring stretch. I figured since you're the qualified physiotherapist, you'll do the rest.
Okay, should we get started then?
Let me help you with that.
I can do it, Warren.
Jess!
I said I can do it, Warren.
Alright, fine, you can do it. Hey! You could do it, huh? And how'd that work out for you? Because from here, it didn't look that impressive.
Shut up.
Look, Jess, why won't you let me help you?
Because I shouldn't need help to do something so simple as get out of bed.
But you do, okay? You do need help, Jess, and there's no shame in that. You have a dislocated disc in your back. You have a broken leg. It's natural to need help about these things, okay? You can't keep doing that.
Doing what?
Acting as if you don't need anyone's help. Like you can do it all on your own. You didn't just fall over and graze your knee, Jess. You were in a serious accident, and it's time you understood that.
I do understand
that. Then act like it. We're here whenever and whatever you need, Jess. So let us help you, okay? You're not invincible.
Neither are you.
What are you talking about?
What you said the other day about this all being your fault.
I don't want to talk about it.
Well, we're talking about it, so get over it.
I've stuff to do.
Warren! It wasn't your fault. It was the person who was driving the car. It was their fault, not yours. You're not to blame.
You don't get it.
No, I do. I know that ever since we were kids, you felt the need to protect me, and you feel like you failed this time because you couldn't. But that doesn't make it your fault, okay? You weren't driving the car. You're not to blame.
You still don't get it.
How are you doing, Jess?
Okay, I guess. The physio seems to be working. I'm not in as much pain anymore. It's just mainly on the rare occasion, you know, if I move too fast or something. And I get this cast off my leg soon, so I won't need the wheelchair anymore, so that's good. My memory's getting better too. I think I'm starting to remember what happened.
Jess, you okay?
I'm fine.
It's great that you're starting to remember what happened, Jess. But that's not what I meant when I asked you how you were doing.
Then what did you mean?
I meant, you know, how you're feeling inside.
Inside?
Yeah.
What do you mean by inside?
you know, emotionally, mentally. The kind of accident like you were in, Jess, doesn't just leave physical scars. It usually leaves mental ones, emotional ones too. The ones that you can't normally see, but you can feel them deep down. So, how do you feel, Jess?
How do I feel? I feel like I'm sick and tired of people asking me how I'm feeling all the goddamn time. Like my answer's gonna change. Because it's not gonna change. Because I'm in this fucking wheelchair. Okay, I'm in this fucking wheelchair. I can't walk without those bloody crutches or holding on to someone for freaking support. I have to have physiotherapy 3 times a week to relearn something that I've been able to do since I was 7 months old. And you know what? That isn't even the worst bit. Because if that wasn't bad enough, I have a fucking hole in my lung that's been stitched up but could burst open and flood my lung within minutes and kill me. I'm a fucking time bomb. So you want to know how I'm feeling, Dr. Highland? That's how I'm feeling. Warren, can you open the door?
Jess, come on.
No, for fuck's sake, Warren, just open the fucking door.
Talk about this for a minute.
Just leave me alone, Warren!
So, I guess therapy didn't go so well then.
Well, what do you think, Sherlock? She had a complete go at Dr. Highland for asking how she feels.
I'll talk to her.
No, Mum. She'll only have a go at you as well. Let her cool off. You know what she's like when she's in a mood.
Okay, I guess.
Yeah. Need help?
No, I'll stay here.
Right, so we've got Doritos, sausage rolls, juice, strawberries, and chocolate rice.
Wow, no way. You couldn't have figured this all out on your own.
What do you mean?
They're all my favourite foods.
Why don't you walk the long way?
Well, really?
Don't act like you didn't know.
Well, I didn't. I only picked them because they're my favourite foods.
Seriously?
Seriously? Chocolate chip muffins? Deal with your parents.
Your dad, what's the deal with him?
Well, I asked first.
I asked second. They're divorced, he cheated on her.
My dad walked out, me and Luke.
I thought you were halfway.
We are. He walked out on both of our mothers and now he's married elsewhere with kids. He doesn't feel the need to walk out on. How ironic is that? The man who left us because he wasn't ready to be a father, or the man who's now a husband, married with kids.
I'm sorry.
I'm not. It taught me a valuable lesson. Can't trust no one. Not even the people who are meant to love you. Why are you so stubborn all the goddamn time? It really is one step forwards and two steps backwards with you, isn't it? I don't want a medal, Jess. I don't want you to get up and give me a pat on the back. I just want you to acknowledge that there's here people to help you get through this, instead of you being this insufferable, stubborn little git who complains about not being able to walk without crutches.
What?
Insufferable stubborn little git. Complains about not being able to walk on crutches.
What the hell is wrong with you, Dale? It's like you don't even like her.
I do like her. Luke, I really like her.
Yeah. You have an interesting way of showing it.
No, this is why I need your help. She hates me.
No, she doesn't.
Well, she does. She keeps rejecting all of my calls.
Doesn't mean she hates you, does it?
Well, doesn't mean she loves me, does it? Sorry, it's just infuriating.
No.
Every time I call her, all I hear is the answer machine going, "The number you have dialed is not available right now. Please call again later." I don't know what to do. I'm running out of options.
Okay. So first of all, I'd lay off on all the calls. Just makes you look creepy and desperate. Second of all, it's her birthday tomorrow, right?
Yeah, so?
So, buy her something nice and give it to her at her party. And tell her how you feel, and apologise. But I'd apologise first so she stays long enough to listen to what you have to say.
That could work.
Of course it could. I came up with it.
Shut up.
Guys, everyone get into positions, they're just outside, quick! Grandpa Sam, it's this way. There you go.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You're fine, sitting here by yourself.
Yes, Dad, I'm sure I'm fine.
You sure you're okay, Jess?
Everyone keeps asking me about the accident. now if I remember anything. And if I remember anything, how I'm doing, it's just too much.
Do you? I don't remember anything, I mean.
A little bit. I have these little flashbacks, kind of like dreams. I remember leaving the party and Warren waiting for me in the car. I even remember dropping my phone to the ground. But after that, it's just this bright light.
What are you saying?
I guess I was just scared.
You don't have to be scared, darling. Yeah. Jess, I'm here. If you want to talk about it, if you just want to sit there and not sit there, Daddy's here, okay?
Hey, Dad. I'm glad you came home. I know I don't act like it, but I didn't have to.
Missed you too.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jess and Warren. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you, everyone, for coming. It's been great. Jess, would you like to say anything?
Just let me say this and nothing changes. I'll just walk away.
Fine, you have 2 minutes.
Thank you.
lungs are responding well. I think she'll be fine, but I'm just going to stay in here just in case.
You're pretty amazing, Hector.
Thanks.
Do you mind me asking, Alex, why did you leave medical school?
It just wasn't really for me.
You're kidding. Do you see what you did today?
There was nothing.
Nothing? Nothing. Alex, you saved your sister's life. That's hardly nothing. You know, when I was your age, I was in the same predicament.
What, you were also a 20-year-old med school dropout that saved their sister from acute respiratory failure?
Not quite. No, I was trained to be a veterinarian.
Really? What happened?
I didn't think I could do it.
So you quit?
Exactly.
What did Grandpa Sam and Grandma Lizzie have to say about that?
They weren't happy. I remember my dad shouting at me for a week.
What about Mum? I bet she wasn't happy.
Well, Mum and I were married for a couple of months, but she supported my decision. Besides, she was carrying you and I had to get a real job, you know, something that paid, actually.
So you quit becoming a veterinarian because of me?
What? No. I quit because I couldn't handle it. I quit because I didn't think I could do it. Alex, don't make the same mistake. It's one of the worst decisions I've ever made in my life. I know you can do it. And I've got a feeling deep down you know you can do it. You proved yourself wrong today. You did something you thought you couldn't do. Just remember that.
Thanks, Dad.
No problem. I'm knackered. I'm going to go to sleep. Do you need anything? A blanket or a pillow?
No, I'm good.
Oh, my darling. Good night, baby.
Night, Dad.
Love you.
Love you too.
You are very lucky your big sister knew what she was doing. It could have ended really bad.
I know. She's a great big sister.
It was nothing.
It was more than nothing. You should consider going back to med school.
I will.
Jess, about yesterday.
Look, forget about yesterday.
Can we talk in private?
Don't worry about us. I feel like we're not even here, you know?
Jess, I don't think that's a good idea considering what happened yesterday.
Alex, please.
Alright, but if you need anything, just shout. Come and talk, I'll make you a cup of tea or something.
Hey, about yesterday.
Dylan, look. Let's forget about yesterday. I know I want to.
Look, Jess, it's been something I've been trying to tell you, and every time I try, something just goes wrong. I'm just going to try and say it again, and I just need you to sit there and not say anything until I finish, okay?
Okay.
Look, Jess, ever since I met you, it's like I can't even function properly. It's like all I do is think about you. I can't eat, I can't sleep. I just sit there thinking, what is she doing? Is she smiling? So ever since my dad left, I found it really hard to trust people. And to open up to people, and just ever since I met you, it's just different. I know it's only been 6 months, but I know technically we're not even dating, but I want to be with you. I want to make you happy. I want to be responsible for your smile, responsible for all the great memories you have and will make. I want to be a part of it. And I know sometimes in the past I've made mistakes, and I just can't help it whilst I'm around you. It's like my foot's permanently stuck in my mouth, and you know when you have something in your head and it sounds like the right thing to do, and you say it and it just comes out wrong. That's what you do to me. You turn me into a babbling idiot. But I'd rather be an idiot who's in love than some straightforward thinking guy who doesn't know what love is. I just want to forget about what happened at the park the other day. I just want to start over. I want to start from today, from this moment. What do you say? Can we start again?
I don't know. It's not like boyfriend material. I'm joking, you donut. Of course we can start again.
I really like you.
I really like you too.
Jess, you guys finished yet? Because the doctor...
Okay, I can go make him another cup of tea or something. You guys take your time.
I just thought, you know, because of the other day.
But nothing happened the other day.
No, but it could have.
But it didn't, Joe. Okay, and whatever idea you've got in the head of yours, just get rid of it.
Why are you pretending like nothing happened? If it didn't, we wouldn't have been in that situation, Leah.
Joe, please just stop.
I'm not going to stop. Why? Because I still got feelings for my wife.
But I'm not your wife. We are divorced, remember?
Okay, my ex-wife. It's only just titles, Leah. Look, whatever we're called, I still love you. And I know you love me. So stop pretending.
You're doing something wrong.
I'm not doing nothing wrong. Look, I know you're scared to open up your heart. And you think I'm going to hurt you, but I won't. I won't make that mistake again, Leah, I promise you.
But how do you know that? Hmm? Can you guarantee that? And what about her, Sharon? Where does she fit in all of this? What, he could be one of these guys that has more than one girlfriend and you see us as and when you can?
What? Sharon's out of the picture. She's gone months ago.
Oh, really?
And look, if I didn't mean it with my tail between my legs, I wouldn't be having this conversation. Look, I love you, Leah. I love you. And I know you love me. So stop fighting it. Okay? Because I'm yours. I'm yours forever. Forever.
Why are you eating cereal in a soup bowl in the middle of the day? What do you think it's about?
Don't know, but it sounds serious.
Mum?
Can I join you?
It's a free country. You can do what you like.
Why are you eating cereal in the middle of the day?
I'm hungry.
can tell me what's going on.
Am I legally obliged to?
No. No, you don't have to say anything. I have found that it does help the situation if you have all the information.
Okay. Well, when you and Dad filed for that divorce, I prayed for weeks that you'd get back together. That it was all some cruel illusion, but it wasn't. And you didn't. Eventually, Dad moved to Australia, and I got used to it. Eventually, we all did.
So I thought you'd be happy that we're giving it another go.
No, I am. I don't know. I just feel like...
But if it didn't work out, just start all over again.
Yeah.
Warren, your father and I, we would never do anything to hurt you, kids. You do know that, don't you? Especially on purpose. Dad and I, we've history. There's something still there. I owe it to myself to find out what it is. And I'd like all of you to be okay with that.
Do you still love him?
Yeah. I think I still do.
Okay.
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 So, we're good? Everything is good?
Yeah.
Come on, then, give him a hug. Oh, you know I love you, baby, don't you?
I love you too, Mum.
Warren?
Yeah?
Glasses.
I don't wear any, but thanks for looking out, Mum.
Wine glasses.
What?
Oh! 2 seconds.
So has everyone packed for the beach tomorrow? Some lotion, swimwear?
Yeah.
So is your boyfriend? Or are you one of those couples that share everything? It's not personal space.
That doesn't even make sense, you idiot.
Oh, shut up. Hey, Mum, have you moved them again?
They're in the cupboard, look now. Down the bottom.
Oh, they're not here. Mm.
You invited dinner?
Yeah. Alex is bringing them. This is fine.
It's fine.
Look at her. I've not seen her this happy in ages. I know you want to protect her, but she's a big girl now. And so what if she brings her boyfriend?
I suppose.
Warren, have I found the glasses yet?
You okay?
I'm scared as fuck.
Hey, I know. It's gonna be okay.
How do you know?
I just do. And when you get out...
If I come out...
When you get out, I'll be here waiting for you, okay?
Okay. Ready? Just in case. Ready?
What's taking so long? What if something's happened?
It depends on the complexity of the operation.
For those who don't attend medical school, what does that mean?
It means that it's usual for it to be taking long.
I can't keep waiting around. I'm gonna go and get a coffee. Does anyone want anything?
It's gonna be fine. That little girl's a tough cookie.
I know, she's like, I just want to be by her side, that's all.
And you will, I promise.
Here we go. So what do penguins wear for the beach? Flipper flops. That's not even funny. That's not even funny. I'm telling you, tuxedo would have been funny.
Yeah, that's
right.
I was convinced
it was
under the
tuxedos. Yes,
yeah. Of course.
Something.
Yeah, that would have been
built
house. Oh, you're a bit late.
Yeah, no, you're really late.
a temptation. They're all in my face. I need to stop waiting. My world's a disgrace. There's beauty tomorrow, but that's not today. When will I stop dreaming? When will I learn to stay? Starts to pass by. I've learned to develop my light, but in turn I still forgot about the fight at hand. When did my heart get so violent? Rejecting the closeness of others, I can't even blame it on the loss of my mother no more. If we settled the score, should that even be standing? A jar of hearts across the landing.
I've been had the sauce since I had a Facebook. She wanna leave with me, it's all on her face. Look, I bring her back to mine so she can get shh. Been on the M with doing them trips. I had to slow down cause I ain't tryna get Nick. Frizz want me in cuffs, they raided my mom's bits. But they didn't find shit, I'm you smarter than this. Hey, I'm you smarter than that. For me, nobody can chat. I had the sauce way before Snapchat. And I don't wanna hear back chat. It's still 10 toes, man, I don't lack. Bring a girl around me, guarantee she get tapped. And she ain't coming back. Hey, she ain't coming back. She wanna leave with me, what can't you tell? She feeling what I'm saying like it's written in braille. Big belly boys, so you know I eat well. Trap phone sounding like alarm bells. Three of my guys locked in the jail cells. I know my guys, them going through hell. Ay, so don't tempt me. Man's got a thing on me, though, don't tempt me. Cause she can get took. I've been had the sauce since I had a Facebook. She wanna leave with me, it's all on her face. Look, I bring her back to mine so she can get shh. Been on the M with doing them trips. I had to slow down cause I ain't tryna get Nick. Frizz want me in cuffs, they raided my mom's bits. But they didn't find shit, I'm you smarter than this. Girl around me cause she can get took. I've been had the sauce since I had a Facebook. She wanna leave with me, it's all on her face. Look, I bring her back to mine so she can get shh. Been on the M with doing them trips. I had to slow down cause I ain't tryna get Nick. Frizz want me in cuffs, they raided my mom's bits. But they didn't find shit, I'm you smarter than this. And we did licks. Jake's pulled up in the X5, I was trapping for the X6. Can't get caught by these feds, I might get life if they find these sticks. From time I've been cutting up bricks, and I'm still tryna make cash flip. If a girl look good, she get dicks. And the up boys still get dick. Get dip, get dip. And I got the Ramsey on hip, on hip, on hip. So don't give none of my guys them lip. Aye bro, what you rolling up? Well you might as well add that chip. Aye, told the other side don't chat shit, I might split your wig. Not really a girl around me cause she can get took. I've been had the sauce since I had a Facebook. She wanna leave with me, it's all on her face. Look, I bring her back to mine so she can get shh. Been on the M with doing them trips. I had to slow down cause I ain't tryna get Nick. Frizz want me in cuffs, they raided my mom's bits. But they didn't find shit, I'm you smarter than this. Girl around me cause she can get took.
but she can get top. She wanna leave with me, it's all on her face, look. Can't bring her back to mine so she can get. Been on the M with them trips. Friends want me in cops, they raided my mom's bits, but they didn't find shit, I'm who's smarter than this.
When I see